Hi everyone, this is Luxdose, and today I'm bringing you another WeCorus video guide. Recently, WeCorus released their new recent app, WeCorus Companion. What does it do? It allows you to update all of your WeCorus directly in-game through the Wego website. So, usually what you had to do before, you had to go manually onto the website, check for a new update, import it into the game, make sure everything was all right. It was a bit tedious, right? So they simply released a software allowing you to do that all in game. It is fantastic. It's lightweight. It performs really well. And let me tell you right now, you do need this. Okay, so let's get right into it. The first thing you're going to need to do is download the new software, WeCorus Companion. Go to wecorus.wtf. Directly, you will be on this little website here. You can download for Windows, Mac, or Linux. So go ahead and choose which version you prefer, and then we'll get right into it. So make sure you install it, and you'll be right here, right? So this is a small software that is outside World of Warcraft, right? This is sitting on your computer, and what it does pretty much, it grabs all the information from your World of Warcraft folder with all of the WeCorus, and then it compares them to Wego.io. And it makes sure that you have the latest version and that everything is ready and optimized. Okay, so once you open the software, you're going to get a small screen here. It's a really straightforward application. You're going to have four tabs. In the Help tab, you're going to be able to have access to how everything works, how to set it up, how things are communicating, and all that good stuff, right? So you're going to be able to check that out. The About tab gives you information about the team. If you want to go and support them on Patreons, they're doing magic. They're helping a lot of people out with everything WeCorus related and developing these apps. It is wonderful, right? So if you want to support them out, it is available right there. So we're going to go right into this. We're going to configure the app, and you guys will be ready to go, right? So when you go into the setting tabs, you can choose the World of Warcraft folder location. So it needs to be the root folder for your recent World of Warcraft installation, right? Not the PTR, not the beta, your World of Warcraft folder. Not the retail subfolder as well, just the root folder of the game. Then you're going to be prompt to select which account you want to use, right? If you have multiple, make sure you use your default World of Warcraft account where everything is set up. This is for Wego, okay? So this is going to allow you, if you ever created WeCorus and you uploaded them on the website Wego, if you don't want them to be considered as updated, right? You want to ignore those ores. So that's what I do. I don't want to see my own ores because I'm the one updating them, right? I should not be getting the information back from them. Then you're going to have the client settings. So if you want to show auras that do not need an update or stuff like that, if you want to have what the language is of the client is going to be, if you want to receive system notification, if you want to launch the software upon launching your computer, that is a very good idea. It's going to allow you every day, whenever you log on, you open your Twitch app, you make sure that WeCorus is updated, and you make sure that the auras themselves are up to date as well. That's going to be really important, right? If you want to keep everything working out. Also, you're going to have WeCorus backup. So if you want to back up all of your auras, you're going to be able to select a folder. Everything is going to be done automatically. You're never going to have to worry about losing any modification, configuration, or anything of that sort, right? So let's get to it. When you go into the main tab after configuring everything, you're going to have this little window with fetch update, right? So if I press it, it's going to check for the latest update, and it's going to come back telling me that I have 2 WeCorus package that needs an update in the game. The application itself does not update your WeCorus because it doesn't modify any of your WeCorus through the software. You need to go inside the game to do it. But before you log on, before you open up World of Warcraft, you want to fetch those updates. You want to make sure that it's aware that 2 of those package requires an update, right? So you can have information about the author, give a link to the website, you have the version number, and you even have the latest change. So you're aware of what got changed in the latest update, all right? So you can see here, I have the last tier, Battle of the Zeralar. I have the Weak Aura package letting me know all of the spells and everything that I need to worry about. And you can see that they added a timer for Jaina's Ice Block, for example, in the latest update. So once this is done, once it is fetched for the update, you can go in World of Warcraft. You're going to open up the Weak Aura add-on by typing /WA in the chat. You're going to open up the add-on, and then you're going to see all of your Weak Auras. Some of them might be in the not loaded section. So, for example, all of the Weak Auras that are not related to my class, right? All of my other Weak Auras are right here in the not loaded section. But we're going to close that out for now. And as you can see, those two package that needs to be updated have a small spinning arrow with the Wago logo right in the middle, right? So it says that it is going to jump from version 2.0 to 2.1. And it also says that there is custom option and all that good stuff. So it's going to let you know exactly what you're updating to. It's that simple, right? So you click on it and then you're going to be prompted. What do you want to do? Do you want to create a copy or update the aura? So if you do create a copy, it's simply going to duplicate it. And then you're going to have two package of the same weak aura, pretty much. You're going to have the old version and the new version. So this could be useful in a sense if you want to make sure that you like what is modified. So for example, talking about my weak auras, if I do a big update for Hunter, let's say, which are coming soon, you're going to be able to create a copy, test them out, see if you like them, and then delete the old package, right? But if you want to go ahead and simply update the weak auras, you can simply check update auras. Everything that is modified will be checked here. So metadata, aura's name, all of those stuff have been modified. If, for example, you want to keep certain options, so let's say that I update Rogue Weak Auras, and you did modification yourself to the size and the position of the Weak Auras themselves, you can go ahead and uncheck size and position. There is a chance that things could break, though. Because if the Weak Auras themselves require those size and positioning changes, then it's going to maybe break things. So this is to your own risk. What I would do is I would update the Weak Auras, leaving up the default change and reapply your brand new change over it, just to make sure. Or like I said, you could always create a copy. In this case, I don't really need any of my modification. I didn't do any, so I'm simply going to check auras, update auras, and I'm going to do import as update. There you go. It is updated. It is that simple. I can do the same for the Battle of the Zaralar. I can go ahead and click it, and I don't want to create a copy. I simply want to update the auras, so I'm going to check that out. And as you can see, some auras name were updated. The display triggers condition. You don't need to worry about any of this, especially if you did not configure or customize this. If you want to keep some of these settings that you would have modified, then you can go ahead and uncheck them. But it's at your own risk. You could bug up some stuff. So create a copy, do the update. It's up to you. I would recommend simply leaving everything by default, update it, and redo your configuration on top of it. That's the safest way of making sure that it updated properly and that everything is going to be good to go, right? Import as update. There you go. So everything is working itself out. There you go. The group is now back up together. It is currently loading, so you're gonna have a little bit of lag. This is a big Weak Aura package, but as soon as everything is ready to go, your game should be good and ready to go, and then you should be able to close the Weak Aura add-on right here, and you're gonna have everything updated. So now you're ready to go back into the world, do your raid, do your stuff. And everything is updated, everything is functioning properly, and you don't have to manually go to the website, update it, and have all of that tedious process, right? So, how cool is that? So I really recommend that you get the software, install it, learn it, love it. It is the best thing that could happen to Weak Auras. So you are going to be able to keep updated all of my class package in just a simple click, right? So that's it for me in this video. If you want to support me, I'm usually on Twitch streaming, right? So currently right now, I am recording this video on Twitch live. So if you want to come check me out, say hi, drop a follow, whatever, you know, come hang out, come have a good time with the community. And Other than that, if you want to leave a like, a comment in the description, under the description, and if you want to subscribe to my YouTube channel, I'll greatly appreciate it. But until then, I'll wish you guys good luck in BFA.